Good morning, everyone. Today is the fifth day of our series and the sixth session we are dealing with. And how are you all? I guess everybody is safe and sound at their places and free from taking all the precautions regarding the pandemic. So talking about today's webinar, today we have a speaker. He's a scientist, ICR scientist, Mr. Venkatraman Bansode. So he's associated with ICR as an agriculture research scientist at Central Tuber Crop Research Institute Regional Center in Bhubaneswar. He has completed his bachelor's in food technology in 2016, master's in 2010, and has a past experience in academies for 5 years as an assistant professor. Then he joined ICR in 2015, and now he is an author of 25 research papers and 2 books. So hereupon I call Mr. Venkat sir to please continue with the session.
Okay, thank you very much Prapulya for your nice introduction, and myself very good morning to Food Techies and your team, Sripad, Prapulya and Shivam and all the team members. So, and I'm very much thankful to you so inviting me on this on such a virtual platform, and really it's very innovative idea and helpful to our students, entrepreneurs, startups. So really congratulate you. So very good morning to all. So myself Venkatraman Bansode, working as a scientist in ICR, so as a agriculture research services ARS scientist at the regional center of Central Tuber Crop Research Institute, Bhubaneswar. So you all know about the ICR because our Satish sir has already explained what are the government, non-government bodies, boards, agencies, all everything he has explained. So ICR is Indian Council of Agriculture Research, is one of the government body which are working under the Department of Agriculture, Research and Education that is there, Government of India, and which has the more than 120 research institutes throughout India, as well as different KVKs, more than 500 KVKs throughout the India. And each institute, research institute, have the different regional centers. So all regional center, so regional centers depend upon the cultivation area of that particular crops. Suppose this CTCRA has one regional center, and you take the example of the Central Potato Research Institute, which are located in Shimla, so which have the more than 7 regional centers. So it depends upon the cultivation area and scope of that particular crop. So ICR having different types of the institutes which are covering all horticulture sector, animal sector, and all this. So you know that already explained by our Satish sir. So shall we start the presentation properly?
Yes. I will just share the slides.
So again, very good morning to all. So my presentation is somewhat different from the earlier presentations. So this is somewhat stop my video. So this is research oriented particularly, but I have not included all the slides in the in a research table manner. So it is a superficial idea about the our crop, that is nutritional status and value addition of tropical tuber crops. So that we see the what is the production area and what is the production scenario. We can include all the points in the our the, this tropical tuber crops. Next slide, please. So point to be covered in the my presentation, which includes about our institutes, what is the role of our institute, then what are the major minor tuber tropical tuber crops, who and what is the production scenario, what are the different varieties of the tuber crops, and role of tropical tuber crops in the livelihood, food and nutritional security of the farmers, and then a nutritional importance, as well as what are the products which are developed from the tropical tuber crops, and the problems which are arises in the minds of the entrepreneurs, startups, and who are willing to start their business, particularly on the tropical tuber crops, that we'll discuss. And the role of our Techno-Incubation Center. So we have established one Techno-Incubation Center, and what kind of the operations we are doing through the regional center, that also we discussed. And what are the outreach programs carried out by our institute, our regional centers. And lastly, I have to just give you an idea about the Sahaj Yoga, which increases your immunity. So next slide, please. Actually, our CTCRI, so having the headquarter is located at the Trivandrum, which was established in 1963. And the regional center is established at the Bhuneshwar, Odisha in 1979. And our institute is one of the institutes in the world which are dedicated exclusively for the research on the tropical root and tuber crops. So it gives the information about the tropical tuber crops through all the world, and we especially exclusively work on this only tropical root and tuber crops other than the potato, because potato have a separate research institute. And mandate of our institutes, which include the basic strategic and applied research for generating the technology which enhances the productivity and utilization for potential of our tuber crops. And it also acts as a national repository of scientific information, like our germplasm and all different varieties and all the planting materials. So all scientific information is available with our institute, and also coordinate the network research with state agriculture universities and generate the location specific technologies. And also act as a human resource developments, which are work particularly involved in the tuber crop research and the developments, and undertake the transfer of technology through the different consultancies, outreach programs, and linkage with the different agencies. Next slide. So the regional center is located at Bhuneshwar. The idea behind to establish the regional center is that, see, Odisha and adjacent state of the Odisha are majorly growing the tuber crops, particularly the sweet potato, yam, and other major and minor tuber crops. So to do the research on that particular crops, so it is easy to for the work and our headquarter. So that's why it is not possible to cover all the research activities throughout India. That's why they have established at regional center at Bhuneshwar, and our working area is belongs to particularly eastern state and our northeast states also. And our priority work is basically on the varietal development of the different kinds of the tropical tuber crops, and supply the disease-free planting material, that is very important, and population of our technology, whatever technology we have developed through the our varieties and other production methods, agronomic practices, whatever the technology we have developed, we have to disseminate to the into the farming community. And also these two last two points are related to our food technology. So last 3 days, in last 3 days, the Prime Minister also reviewed the ICR and urged to our Director General of ICR to reduce the malnutrition through your different varieties to bifortified varieties. Particularly, you increase the zinc content, protein content, whatever may be the micronutrients, so vitamin, minerals, and developed that variety and give to the farming community so as to reduce the malnutrition, because Odisha is also one micronutrient malnutrition is prevalent in the Odisha state. And value addition of the tuber crop, that two last two points are related to my discipline. Next slide, please. So you see, these are the categories of the major tropical tuber crops, minor tuber crops. We have only read only the cassava, tapioca, you know, and sweet potato. So other than this, elephant putiam is also having very good potential in the Odisha and even Bihar and Jharkhand and the Chhattisgarh and even Andhra Pradesh, also West Bengal. So they are also cultivating the elephant putiam. It is also the jimikand. It is also called, in Marathi, it is called as suran. And other white yam, lesser yam, greater yam, these are the diaspora species. Another taro is also there, is called Colocasia. So these are the major one, and minor ones, that's jain taro, swam taro, tania, Chinese potato, yam bean, arrowroot. Arrowroot, that one biscuit is prepared by the Britannia with the help of the arrowroot powder. So this is also one of the our tropical tuber crop, and cania. So these are major and minor tuber crops. Next. By physical appearance, it is easy to identify So different kinds of the tubers, that is cassava. You see, these are the cassava, sweet potato leaves, elephant foot yam, and yam, that trailing one. Next. Then colocasia. That colocasia leaves we are using our Marathwada region actually. So this is used to avoid our kidney stone problems. So they are making pakodas from that leaf, but they are not using the tuber. So here they are using the tubers. So that very small in size, and you can also prepare a good different kind of the product from that colocasia. Yam bean, that arrowroot, and Chinese potato. Next one. You see the cassava, that is the tubers. So it is under the soil, which having the product, very good productivity, about 25 to 45 tons per hectare. We are getting this yield. Next one. Next, sweet potato. There are different kinds of the varieties. We'll discuss in the next slides. So which having the productivity 20 to 28 tons per hectare. Next, taro. Taro also having the productivity 16 to 20 ton per hectare. Next. These are yams. Yams having the three species, particularly Diasporia alata, Diasporia rotundala, and Diasporia esculenta. That is greater yam, white yam, lesser yam. This first one is the greater yam, middle one is the white yam, and last one is the lesser yam. So by physically they are not looking good, but nutritionally they are very rich and very good for our health. So productivity is also good, about 25 to 35 tons per hectare. Next. That is Amorphophallus, that is the Jimikand, or it is Suran. It is very, very good for health. So, which is particularly used in the some parts of the Odisha. Even they are also using in Uttar Pradesh and even Northeast area. Also, they are preparing the traditional dishes from the Amorphophallus. So productivity is also good, about 40 to 45 tons per hectare. It is very costly compared with the other tuber crops. And one of the farmer from the Jharkhand is preparing the powder from this one, and this it is very, very effective on the piles. If we consume 100 gram daily for 1 month, so definitely will the piles will be cured from this type of the medicinal, if due to medicinal properties of the our Amorphophallus. Next one. So the some points to be considered regarding our tropical tuber crops. They are very, very advantageous as a farming community point of view. So they are very highly suitable for the climate change. They can grow at any adverse climatic situation, and they require very less fertilizers, and even water required is very less, and with less very cultivation cost, because they did not require fertilizers, pesticides, and other things. So definitely the cost of the cultivation is less. And actually this area, this coastal belt, and this West Bengal, Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, so they are always susceptible to the cyclones. So each and every year, so there are cyclones. Last year also Fani, this year also Amphani. So they are very difficult for the farmers. But these crops are under the soil, so they will give the livelihood security to the farmers. Because other crops like rice and other our pulses and other, they totally devastated in the cyclones. So, but our crop will survive the farmers, and it's become a livelihood security to the farmers. And some of the tuber crops, particularly which are growing any climate condition, particularly the cassava. So you can cassava, actually there is no specific condition required for the cassava. So they grow at any climatic condition. So it is very, very important for the farming community, and they are suitable for the organic farmings. So we can also grow organic, because they did not require any fertilizers, any pesticides. So it is best suitable for the organic farming, and most of the farmers are doing also, and productivity also more. Next slide. So if you see the production scenario of the our tuber crops, the particularly cassava and sweet potato is ranks in the top 10 food crops and produced in developing countries in terms of their volume of productions. And you see the cassava in cultivated is about 23.77 million hectare and spread over the continents of South America, Africa, and Asia, and producing 281 million tons of the tubers. That is an average productivity of the cassava in the world is about 11.22 tons per hectare. Sweet potato also grown in the different continents like Asia, Africa, America, and Europe, with the area of 11.91 million hectare, and the production is about 175 million tons, and the productivity is about 10.58 hectares. And this cassava and the sweet potato are very two important crops which are cultivated in India with 0.204 and 0.130 million hectares area under the cultivation, and which having the 4.55 and 1.47 million tons in the annual production. So in India, about whatever the cassava production is there, so 70 to 80 production of the cassava is used for the production of the starch, because it is mainly rich in the starch. And so they are preparing the product like our sago, that is sabudana, chips, flour. That chips are consuming, Kerala and Tamil Nadu peoples are consuming only cassava chips, not potato chips. And even they are only preferring the cassava chips and banana chips. So only 20-30% is directly consumed. And they are also directly consumed boiling the, like our sweet potato, they are boiling the cassava and eating with our the fish curry and other dishes of their traditional dishes. So, but it is in Kerala, it is confined to Kerala and Tamil Nadu and some tribal areas. But some parts of Odisha also, they are now eating as a boiled cassava, like South Odisha part. And in India also, the Odisha is one of the leading producer of the sweet potato. So among all the productions, 75 to 80 production is from our Odisha only. And whatever the production is there, they are directly consumed. There is no any single products which are prepared from the sweet potato. Even Indian market also, I think there is no any product, only except some starch. They are not preparing any snack product from the sweet potato. You see, this is the tuber crop growing areas. So particularly, you see the sandy loam soil is required. In Odisha, they are majorly growing the sweet potato and some parts of the cassava. In south also, there is full of tuber crops. In our Maharashtra region also, some Konkan region, they are cultivating the cassava varieties and some sweet potato. And some Gujarat part and Madhya Pradesh part also, they are cultivating. And you see the northeast also, they are yam and other sweet potato cassava, they are growing. Next. This is the livelihood security of the farmers. They are growing the tubers and directly selling to the markets. So they don't know what are the potential of that crop. So we'll trying to increase the different kinds of the value-added products from the sweet potato, and which are helpful to the increase the economic return of the farmers. Next. Basically, tuber crops provides the livelihood, food and nutritional security to the farmers, so which gives the viable option for ensuring the food and first plus right. So nutritional security and lessening the hunger to combat the malnutrition. And this is our tuber crops is particularly the ancient food sources and are often regarded as the relics of the primitive agriculture. So I want to share one example here. So in our Puri, that is the Lord Jagannatha Prasad, they are compulsory using the tubers. So they are preparing dalma dish, and it is compulsory for the Prasad to use the our tuber crops. So, and there is a tons of tuber crops required, and there is a tons of demands of tubers required daily. And even in Odisha, people also on the different occasions, Odisha and Uttar Pradesh also, some parts of Bihar, they are preparing so many dishes from the our tuber crops on the special occasions, on some festivals also. And our this currently this crop is provides over 6% dietary calories of the global population, consisting the small marginal farmers and tribal community. And among all the tuber crops, particularly the sweet potato has a wide and a nutritional diversity. So which are having some low glycemic to high beta carotene and anthocyanin contents. And Time Magazine also has sweet potato selected as one of the best invention of 2016 for its ability to control the vitamin A deficiency in the natural way, which withstand to drought and tolerance to the viral diseases. Next one. And next, please. Even NASA also has selected the our sweet potato as a candidate crop to grown and incorporated in the menu for the astronaut, which are on the space mission due to their unique features and the nutritional value. And it is the happy moment for us. So we requested the Odisha government to kindly include this sweet potato, by at least wild sweet potato, in the midday meal program. And they agree with the, our request, and they are included in the 7 districts of the Odisha. So to reduce the malnutrition and micronutrient deficiency and vitamin A deficiency particularly. Next. So you see, this is one of photographs from the school we have taken. So they have included in the midday meal programs. Next. Micronutrient malnutrition. There are different kinds of the malnutrition. It may be protein malnutrition. It may be the energy malnutrition and micronutrient malnutrition. The energy malnutrition and micronutrient malnutrition. And, so it is very prevalent in the Odisha and more major tribal states. So which nothing but the hidden hungers, which causes the disease due to the dietary deficiency of the vitamins and minerals particularly. And the comprehensive national survey, so which collected the data on the nutritional status of the Indian children between the age to 0 to 19, which indicates the zinc deficiency, so which is 90% of the preschool children and 32% in adolescents. And for that folate, that is folic acid deficiency, was found to be 23% in the preschool children and 37% in adolescents. And the prevalence of the deficiency, particularly of vitamin B12, vitamin A, and vitamin D deficiency, is between 14% to 31% for the preschool children to the adolescents. Next. So this next slide. So another one is vitamin A deficiency, micronutrient deficiency, and vitamin A deficiency. You know, the vitamin A is very essential micronutrient for the immune functions, and it also deficiency which causes the visual impairment, that is the night blindness, and also increases the risk of the morbidity and the mortality from the common child infection. So again, the survey of the CNN survey shows that the vitamin A deficiency among the preschool children, which are aged 1 to 4 years, was 18% and 22% in the range of 5 to 9 years, and 16% among the adolescents. And among the Indian state, Jharkhand has severe vitamin A deficiency across the age group, and which is more than 20%, followed by the Mizoram, Chhattisgarh, Telangana, Odisha, Haryana, and Bihar. And as per the WHO guidelines, the 20% vitamin A deficiency was identified as a several public health problem in 12 states of India among the preschool children and 4 states among the adolescents. And our institute, our regional center, has taken care of this deficiency and developed the varieties which are rich in zinc, which are rich in iron content, which are rich in folic acid, which are rich in the vitamin A content. Next slide. So this is the nutritional importance of the tuber crops. You all know that is all tuber crops are the source of the carbohydrates. They are not rich in the protein, but they are very good source of the carbohydrates, and they provides the essential vitamins, minerals, and dietary fibers. And another very important thing is that all the tuber crops having the low GI to the having the medium GI. That is the glycemic index. And glycemic index is nothing but the rate of synthesis of glucose into the blood. So most of the sweet potato, having the raw sweet potato, also having the GI in the medium category. But after some processing, we can reduce the glycemic index to the low category levels. So that we have developed so many products under the low glycemic index products. Even another is that they are also gluten free. So we can be used with the millet flour and other combinations. And orange, one of the variety developed by, two varieties developed by our regional center, particularly the orange filled sweet potato, the name of that variety is Busona. I have not mentioned here. The name of variety is Busona, that is orange fleshed variety, so which is rich in the beta carotene content, that is about 14 milligram per 100 gram of the beta carotene is present. And then as per the our RDA, the requirement of the beta carotene is about 3 to 6 milligram for the children, and 6 to 9 gram for the our adolescents, and 9 to 13 milligrams for the adults. So we are fulfilling the requirement of the children and adults, children and adolescents, because after processing it get reduced to 6 to 7 milligram per 100 gram. Another one is that purple fleshed sweet potato, which is rich in anthocyanin contents. So this is an anthocyanin contents of this variety about 90 milligram per 100 gram. But after processing it, it should be in the range of 40 to 45 milligram per 100 gram. And all the cassava is also having the low glycemic index and also having the resistance starch. The sweet potato are very the another different varieties which are in antioxidants and beta carotene, vitamin C and tocopherol. So different varieties are there. And another one, elephant footian, that is Jimican suran, is a very good source of omega 3 fatty acids, and you know that is very good for the increasing the good cholesterol level in the blood. Next one. You see, this is a comparative of approximate composition of with potato and other rice and wheat. You see the taro is having good content of the protein, even fat is very less. So minerals are very good compared with the other potato and the rice and wheat, and fiber also very good. So this is the comparison of the approximate composition. Next one. So you know the resistance starch, all the tuber crops, whatever the starch is there, that is resistance starch. You know the starch having the different classification, like rapidly digestible starch, slowly digestible starch, and resistant starch. That again resistant starch having the RS1, RS2, RS3, RS4. But our the tuber crops having the resistant starch means which is resist in the small intestine, it directly go to the large intestine, and it will help like our conventional fiber enriched food ingredients, that is like prebiotics, and increases the good bacterial count in our gut, and which improves the health or status of our consumers. Next. So you see, this is the variety we are specially designed to overcome the deficient small micronutrient malnutrition problems. So zinc content and iron content. So it contains the zinc about 6.3 milligram per 100 gram and iron also 9.1 milligram per 100 gram. So with the help of this, we can fulfill the 75% requirement of the concern micronutrient in the children's and adolescent, and about 60% requirement of the adults. So it's also good source of the vitamin B complex, like our riboflavin and the histamines. And it also fulfills the 25% daily requirement of our dietary fibers, and we're also having the different another varieties. Next. This is greater yam. So by physical appearance, it's not good, but by nutritionally, it is very, very rich in antioxidants, and also having the some estrogenic compounds, and it acts as a some antihypertension, bone protective and immunostimulatory functions, and it is a compulsory type of the tubers they are using in their dalma. One dish is there in Odisha, very famous. So it is compulsory to use this greater yam. Next. So these I have already told vitamin A deficiency. We can overcome the vitamin A deficiency with the help of this orange flesh, that OFSP, orange flesh sweet potato, and another PFSP, that purple flesh sweet potato. Orange flesh sweet potato, that is variety is Bhusona, and purple flesh sweet potato, that is Bhu Krishna. So these are, you see that these are orange color is of this OFSP, and this first one is, that is the purple flesh sweet potato. And we also make one dish, you see the different varieties of the tubers, and their wild tubers also we cut and we have kept into the this plate. So we are called is at a rainbow diet plate, and we are popularizing this rainbow diet plate into the northeast regions. Next. So why there is a need of processing? There is actually all tuber crops are very good and nutritive, rich in the minerals and other vitamins content. But some of the tubers like our cassava is having very less shelf life. So within 72 hours we have to process it. So and your sweet potato also having within a week, so it will deteriorate. So that's why it is need to be converted into different value-added products. And majorly all these product are consumed as a boiled one and as a vegetable consumption. But beside the serving is an they place an insurance crop. So as a time of the food scarcity, I want to share one example. So this area is always susceptible to cyclone and flood and the heat waves and all these things. So when there in 1999 there was super cyclone in the Odisha, so all the crops which are standing crops are devastated, totally completely destroyed by the with the cyclones, and there is a huge problem of the food grains and other pulses and other things. So that time our crop has survived to the farmers, that is tuber crop, because it is under the soil, so it will not affect the tubers. And really, that time the government of Odisha realized that really this kind of the crop is very, very needed at the time in that situation. So from that time onwards, the Odisha government is also helping to our institute and giving so many projects to increase or expand our area of the tuber crops. And so it regarded as one of the branded as a poor man's crop in rural areas, because so by physical appearance, even we people are also, I'm also not taking this kind of these particular tuber reach in this one, and now we are taking in our daily diets. Really, they are very good. And they are also having the high-end products for food and feed and industrial uses. Next one. Next slide, please. You see, these are, I have tried some products from the orange flesh sweet potato varieties. The first one, we have prepared jam, some chips also, and some sticks also, and powder. So that are under the process, and it is under the contract research. So that's why I have not explained all these things. But these kind of the new products I have developed through this variety. Next one. This is also, you see, this is a natural color. Huh? This is the natural color of the jam, which are prepared from that purple flesh variety. Even pasta we have developed from the this variety, powder also. And another products we have also launching. Next. We have tried with vacuum fried chips of the both the varieties. You see the carotenoid content is about 6.8 milligram in the finished product, and compared with your control sample, that is 4.28 milligram per 100 gram. And you see the oil content also 12.39% oil content in vacuum fried, and compared with your control sample is 22.76. In purple flesh sweet potato also, the anthocyanin content is increased by 86% and 35.6% decline in the oil content. So really, they are looking very good, and there is a lot of demand from the entrepreneurs from the this area. Next one. We have developed some functional foods from the tuber crops, like a high beta carotene rich sweet potato. So that is about 8 milligram per 100 gram. That pasta we have developed, and this is a patented technology and promoted by the AgroVinnovet. And then low glycemic index sweet potato noodles we have developed, having the glycemic index is 54.5. There is glycemic index have different ranges, like low glycemic index, medium glycemic index, and high glycemic index. So that low glycemic index less than 55 glycemic index number, and from 56 to 69 it is a medium one, and more than 70 is in a high glycemic index. And our whatever the product we have developed, it is having the glycemic index 54.58. It is also promoted by the AgroVinnovet. And gluten-free noodles we have also developed that from our sweet potato, and it is good for the celiac disease persons. But it is under the category of the medium GI food. It is 62 to 65 glycemic index, and good for the diabetic patients. Next. We also developed some antioxidant rich noodles, different, all they are the natural colors. We have major and minor tuber, tropical tuber crops. So some anthocyanin rich varieties having some yam, which having the anthocyanin rich variety. We have developed the noodles from this one. You see this raw and cooked one. So in curcumin also, one of our tuber also rich in curcumin. So we have developed this one. Even betaine also, and curcumin, betaine, that combination, we have developed these noodles. Next. Fiber rich, we have tried the fiber rich pasta because it is good for the obese and diabetic patients, and the slow digestibility of the fiber in this pasta from the sweet potato, and it's coupled with the high level of the residual undigested starch make this pasta ideal for the our patients, which are diabetic patients as well as the obese people. Next. High protein pasta we have also developed, because all the sweet potato is gluten free one, and we have fortified with the protein sources like whey protein concentrate, deep-fried soy flour, and the fish powder. So this is also high protein pasta is purchased by the this technology has already purchased by the from the Kerala area. Next. Gluten-free noodles from the sweet potato and rice combinations. We have blended the rice and the sweet potato, and the protein content, which having the protein content is in the range of 12 to 7 per 17, and which fortification of the whey protein concentrate is about 10 to 20%, along with our gavar gum. And all these products, these gluten-free noodles, we have exhibited at in vitro, that starch digestibility, and estimated the glycemic index, it is about 55. So it is under the medium glycemic index. Next one. We also tried to prepare cookies from the both the sweet, both the varieties, that biofortified varieties. And now the Prime Minister also interested in last 2-3 days he has issued and that urged to our Director General, so kindly make some biofortified varieties so as to our that overcome our the malnutrition problems. So these our two varieties are best suitable, that's biofortified varieties. And this one orange cluster one, we have prepared cookies from this orange one, and this purple one is from purple precious sweet potato. You see the carotenoid content and anthocyanin content in this one. So carotenoid content is about 3.23 milligram per 100 grams, and anthocyanin is 284.92 milligrams. So that is good for the children. So they fulfill the requirement of carotenoid contents, and also the mineral contents, they fulfill the requirement of the mineral contents. Next one. And this is sweet potato pickle we have prepared. This is the pickle prepared by our self-help groups, and we have transferred this technology to the self-help groups. And so actually Odisha people are very fond of this pickle consumption. So Ganjam district is very popular in that one. They are preparing different kinds of the pickles, like our carrot pickles and different vegetable pickles. So this is one of the pickles is very helpful to the this self-help groups, and they are preparing in a large quantity and selling into the domestic and local market. Next one. Some of the fried products we have prepared from the cassava flowers. So we'll see the products. Next one. So we prepare the flour first, that which are gluten-free one and having the low glycemic index. So that flour is gluten free, so that's why we have to need to fortify it with the another dal flour or any other type of the flours. Next one, and make the different snacks. So we have already, these products are in the market. This hot sticks and pakkavada is already in the market. So we have prepared these two one. Next one. These are salty fries and salty delights. Next. Nutri-chips with with egg and without egg, that is already prepared and is in market. Next one. This sweet fries muruku also we have prepared. Next. This cassava chips we have developed with the good texture and color. So this I want to explain the procedure, like we put into vinegar solution that slices of the our cassava and soak for 1 hour and drain out the slices and blanch it for 5 minutes and surface dry for 30 minutes and deep fry. Really this color, you see the appearance of the cassava chips. Next. We have also developed some pasta from the different kinds of the combinations or different composite flours. Next. Betadine induced pasta we have developed. You see the color, that this is the natural color, and we have added the betanine, so it is having the anti-cancer agents, and it is already technology purchased by the one of the entrepreneurs from the our southern area, is Tamil Nadu and Kerala. Next. Also gluten free pasta we have prepared from the our cassava, so with combination of the rice and the cassava flour. You see the pictures, cooked one, that is first one is from cassava, second one is from rice, and last one that cassava rice combination is cooked pasta. Next. One of our variety from that is yam, that is Dioscorea alata. So first I have shown in the major tuber crop. So this is one of the major tuber crop, and this is having one variety, that is the Nilima variety. So this variety is very rich in anthocyanin, about 60 milligram per 100 gram of the anthocyanin is present in that variety, and we have prepared the pasta from the composite flour of yam and maida and yam and rice flour. this is the pasta. This is natural color. Next. Next. This is one of the product of our headquarters, which are in the market with the brand name of the Kapo. So already we have, they have purchased technology and produced in a large scale within different flavor combination and different flavor combinations. Next. So this is tapioca rava, is also in the market, and they are preparing upma and other ones. Even some self-help group also preparing these products and selling to the market. Next. This our cassava and all tuber crops are very rich in the starch content, so they are preparing the biodegradable films from the our tuber crops starches, and also some cardboards and other they are also preparing for our from the starch sources of the tuber crops. Next one. This is one of the newer technology, that is a botanical extract, biopesticides developed from the our cassava leaf extract. Actually, leaves are having some toxic compounds. So one of our scientists developed, there's three biopesticides, Nanma, Sriya, and Menma, so which are very, very effective against the pseudostem weevil in the banana and red palm weevil in coconut and sucking pest in vegetables. And it's totally organic, natural, and eco-friendly. It's having a very less cost, and it is a waste material. Even Kerala government also focusing on giving funding to this kind of the project, and it is totally 100% controlled to the target pest. Even our agriculture center agriculture minister also appreciate this kind of the work, and he also that promoted this kind of technology on the national level. So we are popularizing our this kind of the biopesticides. Even the, some people from Odisha also, they are using this one. Next. Our division has developed some mobile starch extraction plant, because the all tuber crops are very good source of the starch, and that if you give the planting material of the cassava and arrowroot and other sweet potato, they it is very difficult to extract the starch for the farmers. So that's why we have developed it, and it is on farm starch extraction we can do with the help of this, and it is very easy for operation. There is no need to any skill the person, so farmers can do. Next one. This also, this three types of the machines we have developed, that is chipping machines, hand operated, pedal operated, and motorized chipping machines also developed, and which gives the very easy in operations, and there is no need to require any special kind of the operation methods, and we can produce uniform size of the chips. We can maintain the thickness, we can adjust the thickness if for the flour for you require different kinds of thickness, for the chips we can require different kinds of thickness. That kind of thickness we have maintained it, and is a low operation cost, and so you see the output of this motorized one, about 290 kilogram per hour. This is the efficiency of that machine. Next. This is very, very important. So initially when I was joined as a food technology, because the work of food technology is having that in different sectors. So industrial people are doing in a different way, academic people are doing in a different way, and food technology in the CFTR and other institute, they are doing in a different way, because their aspect is different, and our ICR is totally for the farmers community. So when I joined here, and I have surveyed all the districts, there are 30 districts in the Odisha, I visited all the 30 districts, and I have seen, along with my another scientist, another colleagues who are having expert in the soil and other agronomic practices, we went all the districts and discussed. We see the potential area of the Odisha, so where we can cultivate, where we can increase our production. So and discussed with the farmers, discussed with the entrepreneurs, and after that I have concluded some problems, because cassava is already having some industrial importance from the starch and other one, and already products are in the market, but there is not a single product from the sweet potato in the market. So that's why, So I'm thinking is that, so in at least Odisha, we have to release, we have some established some industries so as to make some products from the our sweet potato. And so I have gone through the farmers and other things. So I found some problems. That is, they told that having the planting material supply, they told us, sir, we don't have some planting material supply and uniform that same variety they are required. So we have taken action regarding this problem and we are supplying the disease free planting materials. So we actually, we are not supplied to all farmers and all districts. That's why we have planned that. So we supplying the planting material to the Krishi Vidyan Kendras, state departments for their nursery. They will develop there and they will provide to the farmers, concerned farmer and potential areas. And then next is cost of cultivation. So we are providing, we have a provision to supply the planting materials. So we are providing the planting material in a very, very less cost, about 0.5 paisa per cuttings. So it is very less. So that's why the cultivation cost is very less. Then uniform size tubers. So another very hurdle in the processing sector is for the value addition of the tuber is that there is no uniform size of the tubers. So if you want to make a chips, means you have required the uniform size. So we have identified areas, potential areas, and we discussed with our scientists which are expert in genetics and other things. And we are taking trials of the particular variety, identify particular variety, and we concluded that. So two variety, that is Kisan variety and the Kanchangand variety are suitable for the chips making. And we have taken the trials also. And technical knowledge, and people also, they don't know technical knowledge. That's why I have established a technical center. We are inviting all the discussed with all agriculture, horticulture officers, and they have a provision to visit our regional center, technical business center, and training provisions. So we'll give the technical knowledge to the farmers. The next one, backward and forward linkage. That is backward linkage. I already supply planting material, same variety, same. So all these things we have supplied, but for forward linkage, marketing and other purposes. So I discussed with the one of the company, the local company of this, which are located in Cuttack. So, and even some NGO also, they are ready to market the product. So we link, we make the liaison of the farmers and the different FPOs and just entrepreneurs. And licensing and registration. In licensing and registration, there is FSSAI registration is required and other things. So farmers are not interested. So it is difficult for them. So we'll invited the FSO from the this area. And so definitely he is very cooperative. Even I have taken some information from my junior Amol Jagtap, and he told me, so what are the procedure, what are documents required. So definitely will help to the farmers and the small entrepreneurs which are in a starting condition. So will help to regarding in licensing and registration process. Next one. So currently I am handling this project after discussion with the farmer and after the condition of the production area and all these things. The Odisha government is very, very cooperative. I met with the principal secretary of the agriculture, and they have sanctioned me the first one project, that is the establishment of Techno Innovation Center. First, because it is on a model for the farmers. So first I have we got project about 2.3 crore rupees, and I have procured all the equipments which are necessary, like our chips making, pasta, that extruded product, then pack automatic packaging machines, bakery unit, all type of the equipments I have purchased at a small scale level, and which is model for the that farmers and other startups. And then another one project given to my colleagues, that is popularization of nutritionally rich tuber crops varieties, because these population is very required. So we have to provide. So I have made some provision in this project is that we are supplying the planting free of cost planting material to the farmers. It's this nutritionally rich variety that is particularly zinc rich and that vitamin A rich and anthocyanin rich variety. So that variety is a lot of demand is there. So we are popularizing. We have adapted districts. Each scientist adopted 5 to 6 districts. So we are going there. We have recruited some staffs and we are supplying the planting material and all the agronomic practices, good agriculture practices, we are supervising. So last third one is the production of good quality planting material, because that is the main hurdle. So they are not getting the good quality planting material. So we established one tissue culture lab, one of my colleagues, and I'm associated with that project. and we are producing the good quality planting material and supplying. Next one. So this is my Techno Innovation Center, which established at Regional Center. Next one. This is next. This is inaugurated by our Honorable DG, Director General of ICR. Next one. Yeah, there are some facilities at Techno Innovation Center. So we'll give the helping to the new entrepreneurs, and we are also giving the training to agriculture, horticulture officers, and also farmers, students, self-help groups. Some industrial people are also coming from Pedi Light Industry. They are under the there are some programs. They came and they were willing to start the industry on this our tuber crops. So we have also given training to them. And methods to weigh by using for TIC. So there is a provision that they can bring the raw material. If you have their own ideas, they can make the products by paying some charges. We have fixed some charges for particular. Suppose like example is that they want to use chips making machine, so they have to give 25 rupees or 30 rupees rupees per hour cost. So they can prepare chips and they can sell it by their own technology. They can prepare and they can pack and they can sell in the market. Another one is that we also MAU with the different kinds of the entrepreneur, different kinds of the that is private processing centers, so they can use our facility. Then contract research also. Some people are interested in contract research. Suppose they want this kind of the product, so they make the contract research with our institutes, and we are helping in the technical knowledge regarding the production and others marketing they are doing. So next one is purchase of technology. Some are purchasing our technology, but they don't have some capital investment. So they make a MAU with us, and they are using our facility and sell in their markets. Next one. You see these some of the already entrepreneurs that people are coming and bring their tubers, and they are working in our TIC and making the products in affordable cost. Next. You see the they have prepared the powder and they have prepared the product that is our pasta and selling into the market. Next one. Some enthusiastic incubators, so they are very enthusiastic and they preparing even snack products from the cassava and some products from our like pickle and other things they are also preparing and they are selling into the market. Next. The same, these are incubators. Next one. Yeah, you see this one of the product in a trial from our headquarters, that is the cassava. So one of our snack product from the cassava, which are into the markets as a market trial. So they are writing on that is supported technology by the ICR CTC. Next. And this is the first from the regional center, one of entrepreneur. Swine Govindchandra Swine. He is the retired bank manager, and he is also willing to start business from the sweet potato. And he has prepared some snack products like sticks and chips, and he is selling this as a market trial into the market. This is the first product from the sweet potato for regional center. Next. We are also increasing the farmers or with the help of the ministers. So they are visiting our headquarters and regional center. Mr. Sujarshan Bhagat, Honorable Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. So they are also honoring to our entrepreneurs. Next. You see the one of example of the information about technology. Earlier they are preparing this cassava chips, so this both one upper side. So this is, you see the browning and other things, but after modification of technology, so you see the color of the product. So that is the one of the example I have given mentioned here. Next. One company, it is Nutrifood. So in Thrissur area of the Kerala. So they have started some fried snack products and pasta from the cassava flour, and which was inaugurated in last 2018. So they are starting their business. Next one. you see they are selling their counter. This is fried snack product from the same one, Brahma Indica Nutriments. Next. You see these are the different products of their companies. The another one is in the last year, Dora Food Industries also started the products from our snack products from our the cassava, particularly the chips and pasta and some fried products. Next. You see this is the Dora products, that is snack products from the cassava in the market. Next. This is the visit of our director general. Always in ICAR, giving a full freedom to their scientists to work in a very with family, with very friendly with the, our scientists. So in one of the function, our secretary, that is secretary of DAIR, main department, director of agriculture education and director general of ICAR. So he visited our techno innovation center, and I told the what are our plans to approach the tribal family, tribal community, and how we can increase the value addition process in these parts. He's very, very interested, and he has appreciated me also. And he belongs to Odisha state. He knows the different problems and this consumption pattern of Odia people. And our director, deputy director general also, he's very interested. He's an expert in horticulture sector. And he also visited our center, and he told me, you just make a cluster approach, make a cluster of tuber crop growing farmers, and give some the machineries to the farmers, and so they will this machinery will be managed by the KVK, otherwise the state government, and they can prepare the product, and you just make a liaison with the different agencies. Next one. So we see the outreach programs. Next. Yeah, so here there is a lot of opportunity to our food technology scientist in this our this state. So I am the only scientist from the food technologies. There are 4 or 5 institutes are there from ICAR, and I am the only person belongs to food technology. That's why there is a lot of work and there is a lot of opportunities here. Even bureaucrats are very friendly with us. Even minister also, I can directly meet with the agriculture minister of the Odisha state. And really, they are very, very helpful, and they inviting me on different meetings. One of the example I have mentioned, I have given the photographs. So when in South Odisha, so there is a 2-3 districts, so they are very interested. The collectors also very interested to grow their crop and what is the future for their crop. So we made the with collectors, and we make one plan to how to increase the cluster approach. And also one of our alumni, agriculture alumni from the Mahatma Phule Krishi Vidyapeetha, he is a DFO here, district forest officer, one of the tribal district of the Odisha. And he also invited me and my colleagues to see whether there is a possibility of the any production and any processing industries. And we directly interact with the farmers. We are not depend upon our that supporting staff and other staff. So we are also directly interacting with the farmers. What exactly problem is there? Whether they are getting the planting material, what really they are having using the good agricultural practices or not. So we directly interact with the farmers. Next. So we are also organizing the different trainings in different levels, some assistant agriculture officers, assistant horticulture officer, then agriculture officer, horticulture officers, which are related to agriculture field and horticulture field. So, and also we directly go to the field along with the agriculture officer. Even agriculture officer and horticulture officer are very, very friendly with us. And we directly go there. We are supplying our varieties, and we see directly whether this farmer is benefiting from that varieties or not. So we directly, this one example, we directly go with my head. So we are, the farmer is showing with our variety. So it is performing well or not. Next one. This is very, very important is that this is a naxalite area actually. So I dare to go because they are not allowed the government vehicle into their villages. So, but I, along with my friend, that NGO persons, I went to that village and see the condition exactly, whether so we can grow this area or not. So we definitely it will help that people's though will if they grow the our tuber crops varieties. So at least the we solve the problem of malnutrition as well as suppose they in produce in surplus amount. So that surplus amount may be converted into value-added products. So we have provision. So we can supply the machineries and we also make liaison with the different officials, state officials also. So if means they are getting good income returns, so definitely they will away from the such kind of the demand offenses. Next one. This is one of the zero district of the Odisha. Already is a zero district of the India. So very very far away from the Bhubaneswar is more than 500 kilometer away from the Bhubaneswar. And there is a problem of communication and all these things. So nowadays they are there is a increasing the awareness among the people also. So this is one of the aspirational district of the Niti Aayog also. So many central government organizations are doing their experiments in this region, and we also tried to create awareness because they are all tribal areas. Odisha is having more than 70-75% of tribal districts, tribal peoples are there. So we never compare with our developed state like our Maharashtra and other states. So there all the nutritional sectors and other things are different from others. So we are creating awareness. So these are our new, at least we are focusing on the consumption pattern. So processing is another part, but we have to reduce the malnutrition. So by consumption process, so we are providing the nutritional rich variety to them with free of cost planting materials. So we are also supervising them. We are also if suppose they having some problems in agronomic practices, we also providing the technical knowledge. Even we are also demoing some one of my colleague that is a technical assistant is that. Then we are telling about the how we can make the flour and how we can the, use the flour into our small scale small products like fried products, making gathiya, sev and other things. So and actually the problem is that when you enter into that areas, the language is also main hurdle. So some tribal languages are different and the Odia language is different and our language is different. We need some people's local people's to help them. So I also tried to learn the Odia, but the tribal language is different. That's next one. This is also for the creating awareness. So we are celebrating the Tuber Day, particularly in the tribal areas, and we inviting all the even some member of parliament and the other state officials. So just to encourage the farmers and also we are visiting the different KVKs and so this KVK is near to the tribal area. So we visit to the KVK, we are supplying planting materials to the KVK. So they will transport to the particular farmers or particular villages. Next. So in the last, in February month, so the Prime Minister office has given to one circular to ICR to increase your popularity of your tuber crops into the our northeast area. So that's why they have one special project they have given for only 1 or 2 months. So in February, so our director has constituted committees and has they have sent me as a leader to the Arunachal and Meghalaya. So we have organized one program in the Arunachal. First photo is from Arunachal Pradesh, and they are also growing some of our varieties. And we have also arranged some ethnic food festivals. They have prepared their own products. So we are encouraging them with the different awards and other things. Even some Meghalaya also, we are making awareness among the their agriculture officer, horticulture officers, people. And in this COVID situation also, we have sent planting material to the Arunachal and Meghalaya because both the DM, that district magistrate, is very, very interested. Because these are very, very helpful to reduce the malnutrition problem. So we have sent the planting material to Arunachal and both Meghalaya in last week. Next one. So this is also a good opportunity to make the MOU with our National Institute of Public Cooperation and Child Development. So whether it is really, these our varieties are effective to the children's and so vitamin A deficiency and malnutrition. They are also agree with, so they will do the study also. And we also do the study in that is clinical study of the both anthocyanin rich variety and vitamin A rich variety with the ICMR and the National Institute of Nutrition and other institutes. So whether actually they are really benefiting, the what is the bioavailability, what is the digestibility, and all these things parameter we will discuss. We are doing the clinical study, and they are also helping with their data. So this is one of the achievement, that is we have established one techno incubation center in the Manipur Jehu area. So under the, our Northeast program, so our CPCRI has supplied all the machines, and we prepare the machines, and we have established one center. And the Northeast complex area, that is one of the ICR institute, they are supervising this area. Even KVK also helping to us and to supervise this techno incubation center. Next. Yeah, this, and the last one, so this is the very nowadays so many diseases, lifestyle diseases are there, and in pandemic situation is there, so so many problems, people are in stress, and so many health problems are also there. So it is one of the yoga, Sahaja Yoga. So I personally just following it. So the already mentioned by our Santa Dhaneshwara in their chapter 6.1, and even Adi Shankara also. It is very simple. The name itself meaning that is Sahaja Yoga. So only required the 15 minutes meditation. So required in awakening of our Kundalini, and some flex. It is a scientific based yoga. It is not like other yogas. It is a scientific based one. Even some university, Delhi University and other countries university also giving the MD in Sahaja Yoga. So all about 180 countries are practicing this kind of the yoga, awakening of the Kundalini and the flexes or energy centers in our body. And definitely the energy center, the middle energy center, is we create the antibodies, and really it helpful for to increase the immune system. Not only immune system, it also balances the in the activity of the internal organs and remove the stress, increases the concentration. So it is really it's benefit beneficial for all, and it is totally free of cost. And then centers are all available throughout the world. And if you want, if anybody is willing to do it, so we can visit this website www.surgeon.org.in. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. This tropical tuber crops is the future crops, which are rich in calories, micronutrient, and vitamins, and accessible to all. So Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Welcome back after the session. This was a very great and informative session, sir. It was Miss Like. Even with the tubers, we got to know what all the roles ASR has to roll out in his duties and all, training parts and the
because we are not only confined to our discipline. We have to do another work also. You have to know information about the soil and other agronomic practices. We have to learn other agricultural branches also. So it will be holistic knowledge.
Yeah, the name itself says it's agriculture research scientist. So that it may, we have to go deep in the agriculture first, and then we have to think about the food part the secondly, I guess.
Because whenever we go towards the farmer, na, they will first ask, sir, which variety is suitable, which that species, that size is required, what kind of the soil is required. So all they are asking, they don't know whether it's from that discipline or that discipline.
Yeah,
so that's why it is, we have to gather all the knowledge.
Yeah, soil variety, then entomology, and everything comes, it's a combination of every science field you guess in the after we have to serve.
Because we are basically from agriculture university, na? So we have also some knowledge regarding the agriculture.
Yes. So that was a very grateful listening to you in the whole session. We have put drop down some questions from the comment section, so we will go entertain them.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Surely.
Yeah. There is Parab Roy. These crops are essential diet components, but many people avoid these crops for diet maintaining. Sir, please comment.
Actually, na, these crops are under the soil and they are free from any pesticide. You see in the market so many vegetables, so many foods are having the pesticidal level. So these are really, it is helpful, and without, they all are pesticide free. So really they are safe for consumption also. And they are really good in the mineral content and vitamin content, only the lack of the protein contents. But we have the another, so we are not telling that we can take sole tuber crops. Along with the tuber crops, you can take other, your pulses, rice and wheat, chapati, you can take, it become a balanced diet. Na? So, yes. So and our two varieties particularly, I have told vitamin A rich and anthocyanin rich variety. Really, these are naturally color and even some are anti-nutritional factors are there, but we can be that remove this anti-nutritional factors by the some pre-processing like our boiling and the soaking methods. We can remove it, so that's good.
Yes, sir. Next is Vruddhi Patel. Can we prepare product at home from this tubers?
Yeah. This is first this home scale product. If you want to prepare, suppose sweet potato chips, I will tell just one procedure. So you take the sweet potato, you just peel it and don't boil. So if boil it means it will that it will gelatinize and we cannot prepare the chips. If you want to make flour, then you can boil and you dry it for chips making. You just remove the peel it and cut the slices and put, because there is a browning reaction is there. So we can keep into the if in home scale means you have to keep in the salt and some turmeric solution for the 15 minutes and then wash with the clean water, then shade drying for surface drying, and after then you can fry. This is the simple procedure for chips. Even pickles also we can prepare, even flour. And what is the use of flour in home? So we can also, now we are days using the proteinics and other cerealac and other for your infants also. The digestibility is also very good. So we can also give to the infant also, and even you can also add into the milk and drink it. And you can make also different paratha, and in roti making also you can make it.
Yes, good. Then next is Nidhi. Does this product contain chemical preservatives?
No. So whatever the products we have prepared, so though they have less shelf life, we are not using a single preservative in our all the tuber crops. So we are not using, because the raw material itself doesn't have any chemicals. So that's why we have prepared all the products without any chemical preservatives.
Yeah. Next question is from Mr. Rameshwar Jaju. Can you please brief about the dedication and struggle to be in this position, and as nowadays aspirants need inspiration like you?
Yeah, it's a very good question asked by Dr. Jaju. Actually, this nobody has known what is DRS and other things. Really, it's one of the prestigious service, and so you are become directly a Group A officer. And for achieving this post, I did lot of efforts, because my intention is that time my goal is to enter into the any government service. So when there was an advertisement in 2013, so there are 13 posts for the food technology in the ARS. But that time I qualified only pre-examination, but I not qualified the main examination, and I failed in the first attempt. So I was very disappointed, and in next year 2014 there is another vacancy for two vacancies are there for food technology, and so very difficult for me, because we have to compete with all India level competition in only two vacancies, and I along with my work I have taken a lot of efforts, and even my PG also I had learning and earning methods I have did, because my financial condition was not good that time, and whole responsibility of family was in me. And so anyhow, my intention, my aim is fixed one, so anyhow I go ahead, and even God also gifted me such a post. Really, it's I'm very happy with this post, and I appeal to all students, so without any hard work there is no any achievement. So there is no any shortcut for the success. So you do with your own positiveness and your efforts, you definitely will also give the success.
Yes, thank you very much. And even he has one more question. What are the strategy to prepare for ARS?
Yeah, so this is also a very good question, because nobody has known about the ARS. ARS is nothing but the Agriculture Research Services, and ARS scientist was recruited by the ASRB, Agriculture Scientist Recruitment Board, and the ministry directly is under the ministry. So they are having the examination like our UPSC pattern, pre-examination, main examination, and interview. So pre-examination is objective type one, and they will not consider their mark. This is only qualifying examination. So they will consider the mark from main examination and your interview. So in main examination is for 260 mark. So they are asking the question subjective manner, like your 2 marks question, 5 marks question, and 6 mark question. That is 2 mark question for 40 question, 5 mark question for 10 questions, and 6 mark question for the 10 mark question for 6 questions. So like that they are have pattern. So after that their interview and combining the main and final marks, so you got a merit and they will appoint as ERS scientist. And same like your UPSC, after selection of the ERS, you have to do the 9 months training compulsory. So 3 months training at NARM Hyderabad, so this academy. Then your institute post, after the posting, you have to have training at institute level. Then professional attachment training in different expert area like CFTR and other CFET and other institutes. After completion of this one, so you got posting at your parent institute and you start your work. And you read the books instead of reading the notes and other things. So you have to read the different reference books. So it is helpful to clear our concept and your that examination, particularly ERS.
Okay, sir. Thank you. That was a very grateful for the students like us and inspiration like you. Next is Raj Andare. While preparing the noodles, what are the different types of bidders were used because tuber are gluten free?
Yeah. Actually, these are some prepared from the composite flour, and this is under the contract research one. So I cannot tell all the ingredients and all the things because it is in research part. So already we are dealing with that person who have purchased the technology. So I cannot explain. After the successful completion of this one, so we will give the details in our in public domain, in our annual research project and all these things. So definitely, but we are using, though they are gluten-free one, so we have to add something into our flours, make a fortified one, and do our pasta and noodles.
Okay. Next is Adesh Dirgude. Is there any difference between Colocasia and Tora leaves? As I have read, both known as alu, which is in Maharashtra, is used for producing vadi, kind of a pakoda.
No, it is different. That is different. I know what another name is. Alu, that taro is the Colocasia, and another one is that. What is the name?
Tora leaves. Taro.
Oh, that in Maharashtra, in Marathwada region, it is called a champura. That leaf is called a champura. Champura leaf is used. They are using. And these are the leaf, and tuber is that Colocasia.
Yeah.
There are so many varieties also, wild varieties also there. So in Maharashtra, there are also wild varieties also there. So
yeah.
There is a difference in their leaf size and tubers also. So it might be the same. The name is, local name is different one, but in scientific, it is called as Colocasia.
Okay, sir. Next is Vridhi Patil. How micronutrients were estimated? How micronutrients were estimated?
Micronutrient, there is a lab, na. So whenever you prepare any product, so we are here, biochemist is there. So they are analyzing the different nutrients. And also if required is there, we are also sending the sample to other institute like our CFTR and other some NIN also. We are having some collaboration with the NIN also. Already MAU from the ICR and ICR and ICMR, already they have MAU. So if there is a non-availability of any equipments, we are sending the samples to NIN and CFT also, and they are giving the results. Even some entrepreneurs are also doing their proximate analysis from the private institutes. But we have a facility. At this basic facility we have.
Okay, sir. Next is, is there any adherent anti-nutritional factor present in the tubers?
Yeah. Anti-nutritional factors are present in the even cassava also, sweet potato also. So in your elephant food, I am also some anti-inflammatory factors which are present. So we can, but that anti-inflammatory factors we can remove by the simple boiling and the soaking methods. So in elephant putam also some itching problem is there. When you eat it, itching problem is there. But now we have that acidity problems we have solved with the some biofortification methods. We have developed another variety, that is Gajendra variety. So that variety is totally is acidity free. But we can remove that much not that anti-inflammatory factors. We can remove by only the pre-soaking as well as the boiling methods. We can remove it. So definitely, okay. They are present.
Yeah. Next is. Just a second. Yeah. Can we say all leaves of tuber crops can be consumed except potato?
No. All tubers leaves we cannot consume because in cassava they are not preferable to consume directly consume. Because some toxic compounds, cyanide-like compounds are present in the cassava leaves. Even the animals are not eating this one. But sweet potato leaves and taro and other leaves, other than this cassava leaves, we can eat by some pre-processing. Okay, not directly raw they are using. Even the sweet potato and the taro leaves are very good in protein content. So by pre-processing and soaking and boiling methods, we can use it. But direct, it is not recommended. Even cassava to never use the leaf. You never use the leaf because the leaf is used for the botanical extract. I have shown this one. So some toxic compounds are there.
Yeah, according to the small concept, only I guess the all of that chamkura is in our colocasia is only edible.
Also, you eat the direct chamkura. There is some acidity problem in your
in the throat.
So this is due to only accumulation of oxalates, no?
Yeah. So, other than that, I don't guess any tuber leaves we are eating.
But another variety also, this Muktakeshi telia variety developed. So these are very having less acidity. Just by boiling only we can remove it.
Okay, sir. Is there any thumb rule to identify edible and wild tubers, miss?
There is no any specific thumb rule, but actually there is a difference. If you use any wild variety, so there is a lot of anti-infectious present in there. So refinement is there. So in whatever variety we have developed, there is a refinement. So we have reduced the oxalate and anti-infectious factors and developed a variety. So, but so many in Northeast area also, so many wild varieties also there. But there is no any thumb rule to identify whether it is wild or whether it is the modified variety. By experiencing only we can do it. But any tuber you want to consume it without boiling, you don't eat whether it is wild or whether it is one. So suppose it is wild. So if it is boiled, we can remove the anti-inflammatory factors easily. And in modified already there is a very less quantity of the anti-inflammatory factors.
Okay. Next and I guess last question. Suggest some agricultural product for reduce the malnutrition and which is easily available.
Actually, there are a lot of products. There is a very this is open sector. Actually, we are confined to only limited mandate crops. We are only working to only the tuber crops. So there are a lot of products, but from our tuber crops, so that is sweet potato. That's two varieties, very very good. And another one is taro. That is zinc rich and iron rich taro is very very important because the people are suffering. Like our, you see the data from the CNNS. So deficiency in the zinc and folic acid. And another vitamin A deficiency is very prevalent in Northeast area also, about more than 20% in Jharkhand and other this thing. So simply our varieties are rich in vitamin A. That variety we can easily use and we can solve the problems. Even Northeast, that's why our intention is to popularize the variety to decrease the malnutrition problem. Just because the Prime Minister is very, very focusing on to the malnutrition free India, and that's why he has reviewed the ICR. And just only yesterday a letter was come from our ICR, so or all institutes, so they are focusing on biofortified varieties, so remove such kind of the micronutrient deficiencies. And already we have developed it and already popularizing it. Only 2 years back these varieties are released in the Odisha. But now we are poplaring throughout the India. It takes time because planting material also is the main aspect. Now we are growing in our area, so it has to be propagated in another area. So it is a difficult task. But we are giving the planting material to the different agencies, so they are also growing. Even Maharashtra also, in Nagpur region, our ex-Vice Chancellor S.N. Puri sir, we also given the planting material to the Puri sir, and he is also growing that tubers. In our way, one of ASARP center is there, All India Coordinated Project on the Tuber Crops in the at our Konkan region, the university, BSK University. So we are also giving planting material to them. So they are also popularized in that area.
Okay. There is one more question. It dropped now. Exact shelf life of tuber types product.
So depends upon the products. Suppose you are pasta and other things, it is 3 to 4 months. And other your jam jelly, it is more than 6 months, 5 to 6 months. So depends upon product variety and other things. We have standardized to this all the parameters.
Sir, is there any research that other than in for food, why what the tubers can be used for, like cosmetics, medical?
Yeah, not cosmetic industry, but that starch, that starch may be from that starch, they are using some gums and other they are preparing. One of our scientists from the biochemistry region, he is making some gum-like product from the, even ethanol also they are preparing. One of our scientists have tried about the ethanol and this gum-like product. So there may be another scope for this one, but we have a limited number of scientists, we have a limited confined work, so definitely we'll try to search the scope in another industry also.
Okay, sir.
Even paper industry also have some scope.
Yeah, tubers are very used in papers. Yeah, thank you, sir. It was very great session, and the second part for the question answer session was also very relevant and important for the clarifications. Thank you for giving your valuable time apart from your working times and all. And we will like to invite you for next session very soon for the students who are preparing for ARS and all. The guidance will be more important for this. For inspiration.
Yes, surely.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
Really, very, very, very thank you, Prafulla, Sripad, and Shivam, and your team. Really, it's giving me opportunity to discuss or interact with our on a virtual platform. This is really a great way, and I'm very, very thankful.
Yeah,
and all your team also. Hmm?
Yeah. Happy Guru Purnima, sir. You're kind of a teacher and guardian to us.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah, very well. We'll come back soon with you again in the second session, next session, third session. We can.
Yeah, surely.
Yes. And there is a feedback link in the description for all the participants. Please give your valuable feedback for our improvements. It is very much required. And I would like to call upon for the evening session. Today, we have Ms. Prajakta Parab, who is going to teach us about what is auditing and how to become an auditor. So I would like all of you to join us at 7 p.m. in the evening. Thank you, sir. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.